I'm in an Office web app right now. This is the Word web app, and I'm working on this paragraph under asteroids. Now, as you might notice, there are other folks, other little icons, other little things happening in these paragraphs. If I go up here to the right upper right-hand corner, I can see there's two other people actually editing this paragraph at the same time. Now, Dave, I don't see suddenly, but he's the green icon, and Roxanne is the purple icon. This is called a real-time collaboration or co-authoring. And basically, you can see people type. So again, I have three people working on this paragraph at the same time. We're all sharing this. Now, I'm not in Word. This is the Word web app. It looks like Word. It has the ribbon at the top. It has many of the features, fonts, styles, paragraph settings. But we're online. The Word web app and the Office web apps are online versions of Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and OneNote. Anyone can use them. They're free. All you need is to be connected to the internet and have an updated browser. Firefox, Chrome, I'm on IE, Internet Explorer, Safari. You can be on a Mac. You can be on a tablet. It doesn't matter. As long as you're connected to the internet, you can work on these Word documents together at the same time. This is one of the new features that just rolled out a couple weeks ago. And we'll show you more of these new features. And just if you haven't used a web app before, we'll stick around because we'll make sure we show you how to get started right away. It's pretty quick. It's pretty simple. And did I mention it's free and they don't even need to have Office? We'd like you to have Office. But you don't even need to have Office to work with the web apps. As again, I could be working with Dave and Roxanne. They could be halfway around the world. I don't have to care about what computer they're on or what internet system. Well, they happen to be in the same room with me today. But that's how the web apps can work. Let's kind of go back and show some other features here that we have in the Office. A couple things that have started off. One, I'm going to scroll down here and go to this table. And you can now use table styles. So I'm going to click on the table, and if you look at the ribbon at the top, a new little thing pops up called Table Tools. That only appears when you click into a table. If I go away here, it goes. If I click someplace else, that will go away. But if I click in the table, I can get a layout tab now, so I can do simple things like remove or delete columns or rows, center things. Then the design tab, I get a lot of different options to make my tables look a little sharper, a little better. Let's try this one here. That looks pretty good. Maybe this one instead. I like that one. So there's table tools now in the web apps. And there's other little things. There's a little thing here at the top, which I think is so small, but I know making it was a big thing. You can change the title of your, I can't rename it because other people are working on the document. Ah, I didn't know that. If other people weren't working on the document, I could change the title of this instantly here. I wouldn't have to do it in some sort of File Explorer or Windows Explorer. But that's why rehearsal should have been done on this one. But again, you can change the title if you're just working on something yourself. It makes sense that you wouldn't have to change the titles if other people are in the document at the same time. As you can see, up in the right-hand corner, it keeps track, but there's two other people working on this document. What other new features? The big one is we took away the save button. Sorry, but let me hold your hand through this process. The save button's gone, but the thing is, it's actually saving all the time. If you look at the bottom of the document in that blue column, it says save to SkyDrive. As I type here, you can see that it will say stuff like save to SkyDrive, saving, and it just happens automatically. So we took away the save button, but it just saves automatically. There's still the save as button and things like that. Another big feature that we add that people are asking for were headers and footers. So I'm going to go up to the upper left-hand corner here and click insert. And I can insert, you know, pictures and clip art and things like that, but I'm going to insert a header and footer. And this new little screen pops up, and at the top there's three little areas, left, center, and right for the header, and left, center, and right for the footer. So I can add the I can add maybe the authors I'll add up here. And then I can put the page numbers in here. So let me add a page number, and I can pick where I want it. And there's even options on the far right-hand side here. It gives you several options of the Word apps, of the options for headers and footers. I can have a different first page, which is good because sometimes you don't want the page number on that first page if it's a title page or something like that. So let me click different first page. I can go to other page here. So the first page has nothing on it. The other pages will have Doug and Gang as the authors and have the page number there. Another command that is startup that was popular, there's now find and replace. And you use the same shortcut keys as long as you're in the document editing it. Control F for find, Control H for replace. So I'm going to do Control H and get find and replace. So if I wanted to look for a word, I start typing the word planet. As I do, it finds planet listed. It yellows it in the main body. And on the left-hand side, it actually pulls all the references in context of where it is. And actually, the word I'm looking for is planetoid. So it's going to find that, and I can replace that. So it finds that there's two uses of that, one out of two on the left-hand side. I'm going to go with dwarf planet and replace all. And just like that, they're replaced. So again, a lot of those features that are in a web app that people have been looking for that you can find in the web apps. Now, it doesn't have all the features of Word, but the cool thing is about Office web apps is they work with Word. They work with Word 2013, Word 2010, Word 2007. You can work with those. So I can save stuff to SkyDrive, bring it off on my computer. I can work with the web app or just open up this in Word. Now, I happen to have Word 2013, so up in the left-hand corner here, there is Open in Word. So I'm going to take this document now and open it in Word. So it's going to give me a warning that I'm working with stuff off the web. And it's going to close the document and open it up in Word. So now I am in Word 2013 as this opens. I have all the power I can do. Now, did you know you can add a table of contents like that in Word? Let's go over to References, Table of Contents, click, and there's a table of contents. Okay, let me save that. Close Word. I'm going to bring it back up in the web app here again. This is the, we'll show you how to get into it and how SkyDrive works here in just a moment. But let me open up the web app. And now I can see the table of contents here at the top page. Okay, I'm in the reading mode. When you first click into a web app, you're in this reading mode. Then if you want to, you can edit the document. So let's show you that. So let's go to Edit, upper left-hand corner, and I'm going to edit this now in the web app. Now, I can't work with a table of contents, okay? It's there, but I can't do anything with it because you can't work with table of contents in the web app, but it's there. What I can do is add a page break, though. That's a new feature. So that table of contents will be on its own page. So let me insert page break, and there's that new page break. So as I go into the reading view, I now have a new first page, which is just the table of contents. So even though I can't edit the table of contents, I can work with it in the web app. You'll find that a lot in the Office web apps. Okay, let's take a step back and talk about what you can do with the Office web apps and how to get to them and all that. I have links in our blog post about some information we have here at office.com about how they work. You can watch a little video. You can read about how you can open, how you can edit, how you can share, how you can store stuff in SkyDrive. But really, the best way to do it is just to jump right in. Go to skydrive.com, you can do it right now, and sign in. Now, if you have an Outlook account, outlook.com account, if you have an old Hotmail account, Xbox Live account, you already signed up with what's called a Microsoft ID. That same login information and password will work, and you can get there. Now, with SkyDrive, you get 7 gigabytes of storage. Doesn't have to be Office documents. Can be text files, PDFs, images, whatever you want to store there. I wouldn't do a lot of videos. That's going to have a lot of weight to them, a lot of size. But 7 gigabytes is about 20,000 average documents. That's a lot of storage for free. And you can use SkyDrive and just open it up with Office if you want to, if you have it. You don't have to necessarily work with the web apps. You can just store things here. I do that all the time. So a document I have here on my computer, if I go home and work on another computer, I can get to that document. I don't have to think which computer or which thumb drive or email that document back to me. It's all in SkyDrive, and it can be secure. We'll show you the sharing in just a moment here. This screen is a couple different ways. This is a kind of a traditional layout. There's also more of a touch layout because, again, you can work with tablets and touch devices on SkyDrive. You're going to find apps for iPhones. You're going to find apps for Android and stuff like that to use this procedure. And then you can use your big fat fingers to click on it. I'm sorry, my fingers are fat. Yours are lovely. You can grab different documents and things like that. You can see what's shared. You can see the size when you last modified something. There's other things about SkyDrive. We'll have links to the blog for about fetching things from your computer and things like that. How to get apps so you can use them and convert move documents very quickly. In the upper left-hand corner, though, you can create documents. You can upload documents. And up in the left-hand corner, let me go to here. This is kind of the suite of things that we have. A lot of people may go to Hotmail, which is now changed to Outlook.com several months ago. So this is Outlook.com. You haven't gone there. It's a wonderful free web-based email. And if you ever at Outlook.com, that little triangle at the top, you can get to your people, your calendar, and to SkyDrive. It's another way to get there. Okay, let's show a little bit about sharing, because that's the main thing about what you want to be doing here. So that solar system down here, you can see that it's shared. Roxanne last worked on it at 9:24 a.m. So here's how you can share. You can see at the bottom left-hand corner, I have permissions. Anyone who has a link can edit this, and Dave and Roxanne can edit this. I can remove those permissions if I want to. I could go over to Dave's name and remove him if I really wanted to, but Dave's a nice guy, so I'm not going to do that. So you have control, basically, who can edit and who can view the document. There's different ways to send it. You can send it via email, and as you can see, there's checkboxes here that you can send it to people just to view or just to edit. You can post to social networks like LinkedIn, which, I mean, you might want to do if you're doing some PR or you want to post a report that you made or something like that. You can do that right from here. And you can also send a link. And there's different links. I can do a view-only link, a view and edit link, or a public link. Now, be careful. Public means public. It's just like if you've gone to Facebook and haven't adjusted your privacy settings, anyone can really see that stuff. Same thing with these documents. So you're going to be really careful with that last link that says make public. The Office web apps, online versions of Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and OneNote are absolutely free to use. You just need an updated browser and an internet connection to use them. You don't have to have Office. You don't have to worry about what version of people that have, because there's only one version. They're updated constantly. I mean, about every quarter, I should say. That's just totally unofficially. Little things pop up, and then bigger things pop up. Next week, we'll be talking about the Excel web app, which also has some new, brand new improvements that people have been requesting. So you can do a lot with Office web apps. And again, they're absolutely free. Everything we've talked about, links to the web apps, and the video for this will be up in a couple days at aka.ms/newapp123. If you have any information about the Office webinar series in general, go to aka.ms/offweb. We'll keep talking about the web apps next week. Dave will be talking about what's new with the Excel web app. But for today's Office webinar team, thank you for joining today's Office 15-minute webinar.